This morning, just days after Larry Nassar's sentencing, the U.S. Olympic Committee has issued an ultimatum to USA Gymnastics. The committee says the sport's national governing body will face termination unless the entire board of directors resigns by next Wednesday. That's just one of six requirements outlined by the USOC. It follows Nassar's sentencing on multiple counts of criminal sexual conduct and more than 150 women coming forward to say that he abused them. In response, USA Gymnastics says it completely embraces the requirements outlined, but does not mention any forthcoming resignations. And calls for accountability are reaching beyond the world of sports, as you would imagine, sparking action here in Washington as well. A bipartisan group of female lawmakers is now calling for congressional investigations into USA Gymnastics and the U.S. Olympic Committee. Democratic Congresswoman Carolyn Maloney of New York is one of those lawmakers. Is joining me now. Congresswoman Maloney, I appreciate your being here. We know you're calling on the Oversight Committee to investigate the USOC and USA Gymnastics. I wanted your sense on if there has been any response yet from the committee chair, from the ranking member. Where does that request stand at this time?
Well, I sent a letter yesterday. I will be calling them today. And it's our responsibility to hear the cry of the young women. 150 of them testified that they were abused. It's a scandal beyond belief. And I think that they need to be held accountable. And the young women have called for an independent investigation. We should give it to them. It's Congress's responsibility. I will be working on it today and hoping to make it happen. This is just the beginning.
So let's drill down on this. The Senate and the House have passed separate bills, per my understanding, reforming how these organizations report sexual abuse. Are you confident that those bills, first of all, can be reconciled and passed by both houses? But more, perhaps more significantly, how would that reform prevent these awful abuses from happening again?
Well, it's a start, but we need to know more, because it was reported in the press. It's saying not only did the girls for 20 years, they were reporting the abuse, not only were they reporting it, but there are reports that there was a cover-up, that they were forced to sign non-disclosure agreements. I mean, what is this about? How many of them are there? And we ought to look at the Olympic committee that was created by Congress in 1978, and they complained to them, they complained to everyone. And Michigan State University failed to protect their students. They received federal funds. We have a federal responsibility to listen to it. And I must tell you, I am frightened by how far this could go. This is just the beginning. There are other people coming forward from other organizations. These were our elite athletes,
and
we didn't protect them even when they were crying and screaming for help.
And Congresswoman, you speak about elite athletes, including one of them who spoke today on the, or spoke this week on the Today Show, Olympian Allie Raisman, who listed who she feels should be held accountable. Listen to her in her own words.
We need to hold these organizations accountable. USA Gymnastics, United States Olympic Committee, MSU, they need an independent investigation. This is bigger than Larry Nassar. We have to get to the bottom of how this disaster happened. If we don't figure out how it did, we can't be confident that it won't happen again.
So she reiterates in some way your point, but the U.S. Olympic Committee is a federally chartered institution, as you know well. The athletes and columnists now have called for that charter to be reexamined.
Absolutely.
Is that something Congress should do? You agree?
Absolutely. It should be reexamined. And Allie went on further to say that they were rotten to the core. So, I mean, these are serious, serious allegations. What's so troubling is that this happened for 20 years, reported. Why didn't they act to protect these young children in many cases from this reported abuse? And what frightens me is I don't think Larry Nassar, Dr. Nassar, I'm glad he's convicted, but I don't think he's alone. I think there could be other cases, and there have been other allegations. They should be looked at. They should be reported on. We should review. How did this systemic abuse happen for so long?
And Congresswoman, just to conclude right now, we know that the House and Senate sides are implementing new training to deal with this Me Too moment with sexual harassment and those types of claims. Are you satisfied with what you're seeing so far, or has it met the bar you think is necessary?
What's interesting is for the first time they are treating it, Peter, seriously. They're taking actions. We will be passing legislation really on Monday when we go back to Congress on for the gymnastics and sports, but also in the next 2 weeks, I believe we will have a reform bill on Congress itself. And I have two bills in that then go to the private sector on ways to put sunlight on these abuses and reporting on it. There is too much effort to cover it up. We need to have a safe workplace for all of our people and to stop it. We have a unique opportunity now with the attention from you and others on these abuses. The next step is, what are you going to do about it to make sure it doesn't happen again?
Well, we'll certainly be watching closely. Congresswoman Carolyn Maloney, we appreciate your time. Thank you very much.
Thank you.